Namaskar and a hello to you. We are delighted to be a part of this festival. After all, art really is life. Art is life, sound frames. And in this session, I am planning to take you into a little journey. A journey to a world where there were no smartphones, there were no internet connections, there was no OTT, no Apple Music, and what have you. But there still was a lot of entertainment. This is the story of a community of professional women entertainers called the Tawaifs. When I say Tawaif, I'm sure there's a million ideas that come flooding to your mind. Well, the fact of the matter is that they were professional entertainers who were meant to entertain a select, very elite part of the community. They were very skilled performers. Many of them sang, some of them sang and danced. We begin this session with a lilting dadra, essentially a love song where a woman is pining for her lover. But the interesting part in the song is that when it starts at a low pace, it breaks into a slightly faster pace. Let you imagine that there's a courtesan doing a little Kathak somewhere in some mehfil. Ijazat. This was a wonderful world of performers. Well, actually, you know, the world of the courtesan really has a very vast expanse in Indian culture, all the way from Amrapali to, say, a Goharjan. But there are many changes that are taking place from the 18th century onwards, where when the otherwise celebrated community of women who were known for their graciousness, women who were known for actually celebrating etiquette, where the landed gentry would send women from their confines to go and learn social etiquette from this community of women, suddenly find themselves in despair. Why? Well, some of it definitely had to do with the Victorian morality that had come into defining Indian culture. Defining Indian culture, defining identities of these very performing women. So much so that there were taboos on what was being performed, there were questions being raised on the lyrics that were being sung. But let us still not forget the fact that this was an incredibly talented bunch of women who actually learned what we celebrate today as classical music in India. And I'm going to actually sing you a small what we celebrate today as a very evolved form of classical, North Indian classical music, Khayal Gayaki. And several of these women had actually trained even in Khayal. And although they were known for forms like the Tumri and Dadra, which are usually referred to as the semi-classical or the lighter classical forms of Indian music, but here were women who came from very skilled backgrounds. And I'd like to sing a Khayal, which has actually been recorded subsequently in the 20th century by one such woman. This particular Khayal is set in the Rag Multani, and it's in a 12-beat cycle called Ek Tal. Nanana me anban, nanana me anban, nanana me anban, kaun si padi re, nanana me anban, nanana me anban, kaun si padi. As well, you saw in the first lot of visuals by Daroga Abbas Ali, a very, very famous photographer of mid-19th century, and he's done this very celebrated series called The Beauties of Lucknow in around 1875 when he does this. It's a series which is actually celebrating women in a context called the Indar Sabha, and in that, within that, The Beauties of Lucknow, you also see musicians who have been included as part of this photography, book that he has done. It's a very, very important and celebrated book of that time, which continues to be a very important documentation for us to understand the role that these women played, how they dressed and what they wore and how they looked. You know, attitude is very important for a performer. And in the next series, you again saw in early 20th century how there was another series of photographs called the Bengali Baijis. This is from actually a book which is dedicated to women, Bengali women who were also Baijis, or the community of the wives who later became known as the singing women or the Baijis. So much had been documented, and also to show the richness of the Tawaif culture. But as I mentioned in before the previous song, the whole perception of the community goes through a sea change, and as a result of that, you see the beginnings of a kind of a marginalization. And what is actually happening here is that a community which was otherwise respected for the fact that they were not part of the conventional confines and yet had a position for themselves in society, now suddenly find themselves on the sidelines. They find themselves marginalized, or at least the beginnings of it. And in this process, what one also sees is there is a yearning or a feeling of being wanted, of feeling of wanting to be included, of being a part of the mainstream, of being part of a respectable community social setup. And one of the leading examples, if I can call her that, of dealing with this transition of from being a bai to a begum, for example, was that of the absolutely stunning singer Begum Akhtar. In her own life, Akhtari went through a lot of struggles, and of course we are not discussing her per se here, but as idiomatically speaking, we see that Begum Akhtar also went through this phase of wanting to be accepted. And so, in fact, when she marries Ishtiaq Ahmed Abbasi, a very celebrated barrister from Lucknow, a well-known barrister, a well-known family, therefore, from Lucknow, her craving is to become this very this person who everybody in the family is very fond of and reaches out to. And there is a point when she becomes called, when she's called Achi Ammi, or the good mother. But to be called that, to be accepted, there is a price that she pays. And for some years in her life, she does not practice as a professional performing musician. This takes, of course, a serious toll on her own life and her health, in fact. But just to say that, you know, there is almost like a turnaround where these women were otherwise respected performers, now suddenly become this considered community of singers and dancers, the same set of the wives who are now baijis, who are now finding a voice in the performance world, in the cultural world, in the social world. Since I've spoken so much about Begum Akhtar, I'd like to sing one of her more popular dadras, which of course made its way into the world of Bollywood as well fairly recently, but this is a version that she has sung.
हमारी अटरिया पे आओ सवरिया, देखा देखी बलम हुई जाए। हमारी अटरिया पे आओ सवरिया, देखा देखी बलम हुई जाए। आओ बलम तुम, आओ सजा अटरिया पे आओ सावरिया, देखा देखी बलम हुई जाए। हमारी अटरिया पे तसव्वुर में चले आते हो, कुछ बातें भी होती हैं, शबे फुरकत भी हो भी होती है।
खुशबू थी उस जमाने की चीज़ों में, समथिंग वेरी ब्यूटिफुल एंड फ्रेग्रेंट अबाउट द म्यूज़िक दैट वॉज मेड एट दैट टाइम. नॉट ऑल ऑफ इट वॉज रियली प्रिटी, लेट मी टेल यू, देर वॉज अ लॉट ऑफ you know, mischievous things going on as well in the world of lyric and in the world of music and on the records as well. Having said that, this is a community that was being marginalized and they felt that, you know, they were losing the performance space. I have to add that this was also a community of very feisty women, of entrepreneurs, of women who were willing to accept and take on new challenges. And perhaps one of the foremost challenges at that time, at the end of the 19th century and the beginning of the 20th century, was how technology came into music. Initially, I'm talking about the gramophones, of course, and initially there was a lot of, you know, trepidation. You know, people were not unsure about what this machine was all about. And so a lot of men actually stayed away from it. In fact, one of the things that is said about why the ustad stayed away from the machine is that they were not sure about sharing a guru shishya parampara, you know, in the sense of selling it to the market. But these women who came from this tawaf background were willing to take on this challenge, and several of them recorded on it. But another very important change, I'm just talking about how they were willing to adapt to changes that were happening around them, was that of sound coming to films. I mean, you can imagine the way we celebrate Bollywood music, and it's unthinkable of, you know, Bollywood without the song and dance that accompanies it. But it happened in the 30s, and even this was first attempted by a woman named Saraswati Devi. She's supposed to be the first film music director, and of course her maiden name was Khurshid. And when she comes into the film industry, she's rechristened as Saraswati Devi. We know this happens to a lot of people, including our own very Akshay Kumar. Saraswati Devi not only created music for film, she also brought in playback singing into film. So two very, very important contributions. And she actually did music for a very celebrated film called Achhoot Kanya, which in the late 30s. I'm going to sing a song from one of the films that she has composed music for. She not only composed music, she also sang this song. And on screen was her her own sister, who was called Chandraprabha. This is from a film in the 1930s, 35, if I'm not mistaken, a film called Jawani Ki Hawa.
Kit gaye ho kevan haar, kit gaye ho kevan haar.
Hey.
this is a very long story. As I said, it's spanning at least a few centuries. So this was just a taste of what must have been a beautiful time in the cultural scape of India. I want to finish this session with what I see is a tribute to someone who was who played a very important role in nurturing these talents, in nurturing these genres, and also himself was a composer, enjoyed dancing, broke many stereotypes therefore, Nawab Wajid Ali Shah. And I choose to sing this particular thumri, which is attributed to him, because I see in it a metaphor that in a sense celebrates the melancholy perhaps that the women felt, a sense of moving away when not wanting to, a sense of wanting to be included. All of that is encapsulated in this idea that Wajid Ali Shah says in his composition, Babul mora naihar chhuto jai. Naihar as in the natal home. And the woman is calling out to her father to say, Mera ghar mere se chhut raha hai. I want to be included. Take me back in your fold, dear Babul.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Hello everyone, we are Neeraj Arya's Kabir Cafe. We are extremely glad to be performing for Bengaluru's Museum, the Museum of Art and Photography's annual festival, Art is Life, Sound Frames. Thank you so much for having us. We would start our performance with an instrumental track called the Titan track, which is infused by a little bit of Ilayaraja sir's melodies. Hope you have a great time listening to this. That song. The next song that we're going to be performing is called Chadariya Jeene Re Jeene. It's been performed by legends like Kumar Gandharji, Anup Jalota ji, and this is our humble attempt at the song. In this song, Kabir is telling us just the way we keep our clothes clean. We make sure that there are no stains in our cloth, in our shirt, or in our dress. Let's make sure that our character is also as clean as that. Let's make sure that there are no stains in our character. That way we'll be able to have a wonderful, wonderful life. And when the cloth and when the character both are clean, everything is going to be happy. So on that note, Chadariya Jini Rejini.
Chadariya Jini Rejini. रसभीनी चदरिया झीनी रे झीनी
चदरिया जीनी रे जीनी चदरिया जीनी रे जीनी हे राम नाम रसभीनी चदरिया जीनी रे जीनी हे राम नाम रसभीनी चदरिया जीनी रे कमल दल चनखा चाले अष्ट कमल दल चनखा चाले पांच तातु की पूनी अष्ट कमल दल चनखा चाले अष्ट कमल दल चनखा चाले पांच तातु की पूनी चदरिया जीनी रे जीनी ए राम नाम रसभीनी चदरिया जीनी रे जीनी
दाम दूम दाम दाम दर ना दाम दूम दाम दाम दर ना
दाम दूम दाम दाम दर ना दाम दूम दाम दाम दर ना ध्रुव पहलाद सुदामा ने ओढ़ी ध्रुव पहलाद सुदामा ने ध्रुव पहलाद सुदामा ने ओढ़ी ध्रुव पहलाद सुदामा ने ओढ़ी सुख दे निर्मल दास कबीर जतन कर ओढ़ी दास कबीर जतन कर ओढ़ी चौकी त्यों कर दीनी चदरिया जीनी रे जीनी रे जीनी रे जीनी हे राम नाम रसभीनी चदरिया हे राम नाम रसभीनी चदरिया जीनी रे ताली बजा दो।
दोस्तों बात ऐसी है कि आजकल इस दुनिया में बस एक बानी चल रही है जो कि है सोशल मीडिया की बानी, जैसे कि व्हाट्सएप की बानी हो, फेसबुक की बानी हो, इंस्टाग्राम की बानी हो। पर आज हम लोग 6 लोग यहाँ सिर्फ कबीरदास जी के बानी के बारे में बात करेंगे। तो अपने अगले भजन में संत कबीरदास जी आत्मा के बारे में, सोल के बारे में बात करें और इस आत्मा को वो एक मुनिया की तरह देखते हैं।
सतगुरु है व्यापार तेरा, सतगुरु है व्यापार तेरा, सतगुरु है व्यापार तेरा, साहेब है व्यापारी मुनिया पिंजरे वाली ना। सतगुरु है वह पार तेरा, साहेब है वे पारी मुनिया पिंजरे वाली ना। ओ तेरा साहेब है वे पारी मुनिया पिंजरे वाली ना। ओ तेरा सतगुरु है वे पारी, सतगुरु है वह पार तेरा,
सतगुरु है वे पार तेरा,
साहेब है वे पारी मुनिया पिंजरे वाली ना। ओ तेरा साहेब है वे पारी मुनिया पिंजरे वाली ना। ओ तेरा सतगुरु है वे पारी। अलखटाल पे मुनिया बैठी पी गई ज्ञान की बूटी, अलखटाल पे मुनिया बैठी पी गई ज्ञान की बूटी। सब संतों ने मिल बंदों बताया, सब संतों ने मिल ज्ञान बताया, मुनिया हो गई न्यारी मुनिया पिंजरे वाली ना। ओ तेरा साहेब है व्यापारी मुनिया पिंजरे वाली ना। ओ तेरा सतगुरु है व्यापारी। पीयूष आचार्य हारमोनियम पे है। पांच तत्व का बना पिंजरा तामे मुनिया बैठी, तामे मुनिया बैठी, हाँ तामे मुनिया बैठी। ओ पांच तत्व का बना पिंजरा तामे मुनिया बैठी, ओ पांच तत्व का बना पिंजरा तामे मुनिया बैठी। उड़ गई मुनिया टूट गया पिंजरा, उड़ गई मुनिया टूट गया पिंजरा,
उड़ गई मुनिया
टूट गया पिंजरा,
उड़ गई मुनिया।
रोवण लागी दुनिया मुनिया पिंजरे वाली ना। ओ तेरा साहिब है व्यापारी मुनिया पिंजरे वाली ना। ओ तेरा सतगुरु है व्यापारी, सतगुरु है व्यापार तेरा,
सतगुरु है व्यापार तेरा,
साहिब है व्यापारी मुनिया पिंजरे वाली ना। ओ तेरा साहिब है व्यापारी मुनिया पिंजरे वाली ना। ओ तेरा सतगुरु है व्यापारी। मुकुंद रामा स्वामी वाले पर कहे कबीर सुनो भाई साधु मुनिया की गत न्यारी, मुनिया की गत न्यारी, मुनिया की गत न्यारी। ओ कहे कबीर सुनो भाई साधु मुनिया की गत न्यारी, ओ कहे कबीर सुनो भाई साधु मुनिया की गत न्यारी। ओ जो मुनिया को लखे लगावे, जो मुनिया को लखे लगावे, जो मुनिया को लखे लगावे, ओ जो मुनिया को लखे लगावे, ओ आवा कफन निभानी मुनिया पिंजरे वाली ना। ओ तेरा साहिब है व्यापारी मुनिया पिंजरे वाली ना। ओ तेरा सतगुरु है व्यापारी मुनिया पिंजरे वाली ना। ओ तेरा साहिब है व्यापारी मुनिया पिंजरे वाली ना। ओ तेरा सतगुरु है व्यापारी। तेरा
So the next song we're going to present to you now is called Ghat Ghat Mein Panchi Bolta Hai. In this song, Kabir speaks about the soul that is there in each body, you know. And he says that every soul is one. And he also speaks about that soul as oneness. So why worry about the boundaries and big or small, you know, division? He says that every living being, every existence is equal. So let's celebrate the oneness and equality in this song, Ghat Ghat Mein Panchi Bolta Hai.
घट घट में पंछी बोलता है, घट घट में पंछी बोलता है, घट घट में पंछी बोलता है, घट घट में पंछी बोलता है। आप ही डंडी, आप तराजू, आप ही डंडी, आप तराजू, आप ही बैठा तोलता है। घट घट में पंछी बोलता है, घट घट में पंछी बोलता बन आप बेराजे, सब में सब बन आप बेराजे, जड़ चेतन में दौलता
क्या करना है कि अपने मस्त होना है और मगन होना है। कबीर ने ये भी बताया कि लाइफ के बारे में भी चीज़ें सिखाएं, लेकिन कभी नहीं आपको पार्टी करना भी सिखाया कि आप इन्जॉय करें जो आपके पास है, जितना आपके पास है उसको खूबसूरती से जिए और इन्जॉय करें। आशा करता हूँ आपको पसंद आएगा। मन मस्त भया फिर क्या बोले। आशा करता हूं कि आपको हमारा परफॉर्मेंस पसंद आ रहा होगा। अगर नहीं आ रहा है तो प्लीज पसंद कीजिए, क्योंकि हिंदुस्तान का एक ही वाहिद बैंड है नीरज आर्यास कबीर कैफे, जो कबीर की वाणी को गाने की कोशिश कर रहा है और उसको समझाने की, उसकी फिलॉसफी को बताने की कोशिश कर रहा है। और स्पेशल थैंक्स देना चाहेंगे म्यूजियम ऑफ आर्ट एंड फोटोग्राफी, जिन्होंने हमें मौका दिया आप सबके लिए परफॉर्म करने का। और दिल से धन्यवाद है कामनी सावने जी को और साधना राव जी को और सूर्या जी को, जिन्होंने हमें मौका दिया आप लोगों के लिए परफॉर्म करने के लिए। थैंक यू सो मच। अगला गाना है, गाने का नाम है 84 की नींद में मारा सदगुरु आके जगा गया। 84 की नींद मतलब 84 नंबर है वो। तो 84 लाख कीड़े मकोड़े जीव जितने भी स्पीशीज आप कहें, इनके जन्म होने के बाद मनुष्य का जन्म होता है। तो ये जो जन्म है ये बहुत एक तोहफा है हमारे लिए, इसको व्यर्थ ना करें, इसको एंजॉय करें और इसको एक मंदिर की तरह इसको ट्रीट करें। आशा करता हूं कि आपको गाना पसंद आएगा। आके जगा गया, चोरा शिकीर नींद में मारा सतगुरु आके जगा गया, चोरा शिकीर नींद में मारा सतगुरु आके जगा गया, चोरा शिकीर नींद में मारा सतगुरु आके जगा गया। कौन था मैं कहां से आया ना जाने मेरा नाम क्या, कौन था मैं कहां से आया ना जाने मेरा नाम क्या, कृपा हुई गुरुदेव की ऐसी आग से हंस बना दिया, चोरा शिकीर नींद में मारा सतगुरु आके जगा गया, चोरा शिकीर नींद में मारा सतगुरु आके जगा गया। ओ चरण का दास था, नानक नाम प्रकाश का पंचम चरण का दास था, अष्टमल की सेज पर एक ही नाम लटा दिया, चोरा शिकीर नींद में मारा सतगुरु आके जगा गया, चोरा शिकीर नींद में मारा सतगुरु आके जगा गया, चोरा शिकीर नींद में मारा सतगुरु आके जगा गया, चोरा शिकीर नींद में मारा सतगुरु आके जगा गया। दीपताना 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 दीपता, 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 सदा बड़ा कबा कबा गिरी, 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 सदा बड़ा कबा कबा गिरी। The next song that we are going to be performing is Mat Kar Maya Ko Ankhar. This song is the song that we are given for Scam 1992, the Harshad Mehta story.
मत कर माया को अहंकार, मत कर काया को अभिमान, काया गार से कांची, मत कर माया को अहंकार, मत कर काया को अभिमान, काया गार से कांची, काया कार से कांची रे, जैसे ओस रामोती झोंका, पवन का लग जाए झपका, पवन का लग जाए काया दूर हो जासी, काया तेरी धूल हो जासी, Thank you. था महाराज जिनका कुल को महराज जिन घर झूलता हाथी
जिन घर झूलता हाथी
जिन घर झूलता हाथी रे उन घर दिया ना पाती झोंका भवन का लग जाए झपका भवन का लग जाए खाया धूल हो जासी खाया तेरी धूल हो जासी कल पारी बार झूठी टूटता छाती
झूठी टूटता छाती
झूठी टूटता छाती रे जैसे ओस ना मोती
आचार्य जी हो हारमोनियम पहन के जोरदार ताली ओ जरा हल्के गाड़िया को ओ मेरे राम गाड़ी वाले ओ जरा हौले हौले गाड़िया को ओ मेरे राम गाड़ी वाले जरा हल्के गाड़ी हाको मेरे राम गाड़ी वाले जरा हौले हौले गाड़ी हाको मेरे राम गाड़ी वाले जरा हल्के गाड़ी हाको
मेरे राम गाड़ी वाले
जरा हौले हौले गाड़ी हाको मेरे राम गाड़ी वाले गाड़ी मारी रंग रंगी नीर पहिया लाल गुलाल ओ चल छपीली नी बैठन वाला नाम भैया हल्के गाड़ी हाको मेरे राम गाड़ी वाले जरा हौले हौले गाड़ी हाको मेरे राम गाड़ी वाले गाड़ी अटकी रेत में पई मछल पड़ी है दूर ऐसी गाड़ी अटकी रेत में पई मछल पड़ी है दूर की धर्मी धर्मी बार उतर ज्ञानी पापी चकना चूर ओ भैया हल्के गाड़ी हाको मेरे राम गाड़ी वाले तारा होले होले गाड़ी हाको मेरे राम गाड़ी वाले मुकुंद रामा स्वामी वालन पर आखिर में आ गए कबीर साहब कह रहे हैं बिलक बिलक कर त्रिया रोवे, बिछड़ गई है मोरी जोड़ी। त्रिया का मतलब होता है स्त्री औरत। तो कबीर साहब बताना चाह रहे हैं कि हम लोग जो अटैचमेंट रख लेते हैं एक दूसरे से, आखिर में तो सबको अकेले जाना है। तो त्रिया जो है रो रही है बिलक बिलक कर कि उसका जोड़ीदार बिछड़ के उससे दूर जा रहा है। तो कबीर साहब क्या कह रहे हैं उस त्रिया को, जरा शब्द को ध्यान से सुने, क्या कहा है? कहे कबीर भाई सुन बसा तू, चिन जोड़ी उन तोड़ी ओ भैया हल्के गाड़ी, हाँ तो मेरे राम गाड़ी वाले जरा होले होले गाड़ी, हाँ तो मेरे राम गाड़ी वाले जरा हल्के गाड़ी, हाँ तो मेरे राम गाड़ी वाले जरा होले होले गाड़ी, हाँ तो मेरे राम गाड़ी वाले जरा हल्के गाड़ी, हाँ तो मेरे राम गाड़ी वाले जरा होले होले गाड़ी, हाँ तो मेरे राम गाड़ी वाले जरा हल्के गाड़ी, हाँ तो मेरे राम गाड़ी वाले जरा होले होले गाड़ी, हाँ तो मेरे राम गाड़ी वाले। Instagram, Facebook, YouTube app, go subscribe, support independent music. Thank you all.